obviously I'm a New Yorker. Pizza is key to my life. And any, you know, any sort of pizzeria in New York will have a great garlic knot, but I'm gonna show you, we make pizzas a lot at our house because the kids like to do it, and it's one of those things that I can put as many vegetables on as I can and they'll actually eat them, which is always fun. I'm gonna show you a little bit of a zhuzhed up garlic knot that's a salami garlic knot. And it,
my husband, John, could Hoover that tray in like 2 minutes.
Oh, he and I should hang out.
Yeah, yeah.
But there might not be enough for both of us. Okay, so here's the tricky parts. It's not tricky at all. You go to your pizzeria and you buy some pizza dough from them, or you can go to your grocery store. Most of them will have it either in the freezer section or in your
Italian
foods,
right?
And then the trick is just literally just a swig. Aha, did you see that? It's a magic trick.
I want to do one.
You literally are just tying a little bow and that. See? Come on. Don't think about it. Yes. And now flip it forwards. Yes.
I'm cheating.
And now flip it forwards. And she's a pretzel maker.
No, not really, but thank you for lying.
Can I tell you something? Honestly, you could do this in a straight stick and it would still be perfect because it's slathered in butter and garlic. There is nothing that can go wrong. Wait till you see it bake up. It's gonna be like a little gem. It's so squishy.
Mine looks like a crawler.
A crawler. Well, hey, I love those too.
It's okay, baby. You're ugly, but I'll eat you. Don't you worry.
So here I have some cut up salami. You can use prosciutto if you really like your guests, but you know, whatever works. Some fresh garlic. I know you and I have a garlic fixation.
Oh, we have a garlic thing.
We love that.
And it's good for us. Your dad would approve,
yes,
right?
Yes, he absolutely would. Here's how I also like to, again, you take a sort of a standard staple, which is the garlic knot. We're cooking in some of the salami with it. And then I take some whole fennel seeds here. Think of your
sausage
flavors.
I love fennel, right, because it tastes like sausage.
So I want to really amp up that Italian flavor. And here I have equal parts garlic and oil with some garlic that I grated in here as well. And I'm going to go heavy on the...
fennel seed, yep.
Can you hear it?
Smells amazing.
Hear it frying a little bit?
It's going,
get me on that cooler. It's so good. So you just want to let this simmer and sizzle until you really smell that aroma of the fennel blooming.
Right?
And then what I do is I dunk them in, but that's a little aggressive here. So we're going to brush it on the top.
No, let's dunk.
Dunk them. If I can give you one key to success on this recipe, do not skimp on the butter dunk. It is patented to make these delicious. And look at this.
Look. Oh.
And then you just hit it with a little bit of your
the salami.
And a little extra salt if you think it needs it. And oh, those look so good.
Look, now, I can't even pull them out without wrecking them.
Here's one extra little bonus
good
tip.
Good thing we got some pretty ones over there.
These, you throw them in the oven.
Right.
These are one of those recipes that, for me, I never bother. I throw them at 350, but I never bother with actual cook time. I just taste test until I know they're done.
Oh, my